Welcome to Learn Commerce PU online classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Hello students, welcome to second PUC Accountancy online classes. In the previous class, we have solved a problem on premium method, that is cash brought in by the partner. Then second method, cash brought in by the partner towards goodwill and withdrawn by the old partners. These two methods we have tackled by solving the problem. Now let me move on to the third method, that is creation of goodwill. Goodwill will be created in the books of the firm and then it will be allowed to remain as an asset in the balance sheet. That is the third method. Yesterday we have solved problem number 8, page number 39. There is one problem number 9, Anil and Sunil. Actually, it is related to the fourth method. That is a goodwill. Related to second method only. He should bring cash for capital rupees 40,000 and 30,000 towards goodwill. Half of the goodwill amount withdrawn by the old partners. So second method. There are no such new things similar to previous problems which I have solved. So I will not solve this in the class. Take it as your homework. Then next problem is problem number 10, Arati and Bharati. That is related to fourth method, goodwill created in the books of the firm and written off. So I will take up later, because let us go one by one. That is the first method, second method, third method and fourth method. I will take up problem on third method now. Fourth method I will take up later. That is problem number 10 will be taken later. This will even problem number 11 also related to, that is fourth method, agreed to write off the goodwill. Written goodwill is written off. That also fourth method. Problem number 12, this is related to third method. So I will take up problem number 12 now. Then 10 and 11 I will take up later, so that we will go step by step instead of jumbling it. So if I go as per the serial number of question bank, then we have to solve problem on fourth method first, then third method better. Let us go step by step. So I will take up problem number 12. I will read out the problem and let us analyze it and solve the problem. Sharat and Bharat are partners, sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 2:1. Their balance sheet on 31st March 2018 is given. Liabilities side, let us see. Creditors, bills payable, normal liabilities. Reserve fund, of course, we have tackled this. Any method for that matter, if accumulated profit in the reserves appears, that should be distributed among the old partners in their old profit sharing ratio. So here also we have to do the same thing, whatever we did in previous problems, whatever we have solved in the class, same thing we have to do. We have to credit it to old partners capital accounts in their old profit sharing ratio. Then capital's opening balances by balance brought down in capital account, you know it very well. Let us move on to the asset side, cash in hand. So all entries should be cash entries, not bank entries, remember. Debtors, stock, furniture, buildings. Let us see the adjustment now. They admit Kamath into partnership, giving him 1/5 share in future profits on the following terms. New partner share will be 1/5. Old partners ratio will be 2:1 or 2/3 and 1/3. Old ratio. The new partner should bring rupees 25,000 as his capital. No doubt, you will credit it to new partner's capital account by cash. By cash, capital introduced. You will enter only in new partner's capital account. Then the goodwill account is to be raised at ₹24,000. Goodwill should be raised. Third method, because it is not written off, it is not mentioned further to write off. So third method, it is to create goodwill. Journal entry is goodwill account letter to old partner's capital account. Goodwill account letter to old partner's capital account in their old profit sharing ratio. Remember, in their old profit sharing ratio. So by goodwill we will credit to old partners only. Then value of buildings is to be appreciated. You know it very well. Appreciation in the value of asset, credit side of revaluation account. By ₹7,000, this is the amount which should be entered in revaluation account. Remember. And furniture to be appreciated by ₹1,000. Again, by ₹1,000, this is the amount that should be entered on the debit side of credit side of revaluation account, because it is appreciation. Again, increase in the value of asset should be credited to revaluation account. Stock is valued at 10% less than the book value, and there is an outstanding printing bill for ₹400. Stock is valued at 10% less, means we have to calculate 10% of the stock value and should be entered on the debit side of revaluation. It is a loss, decrease in the value of asset. Stock being an asset, current asset, decrease in the value of asset should be entered on the debit side of revaluation account. Then what? There is an outstanding printing bill, outstanding expense should be debited to revaluation account. It's a loss to the business, should be entered on the debit side of revaluation account. So that's all we have to do. Very simple problem, right? Yes, let us solve it now. Revaluation account. Column headings. Write it. I will not write the column headings. Particulars, amount in rupees. You know it very well. You can provide for JF in board exam. So debit credit, it is an account, so debit credit is a must. Let us start entering the values. Value of buildings is to be appreciated by ₹7,000. So appreciation by buildings. By buildings account, no need to calculate, straight away it is given by ₹7,000. So appreciation, that is how much? ₹7,000, right? Write the amount, ₹7,000. Then furniture to be appreciated by ₹1,000. Again, buy furniture. What is the amount? Furniture account. Again, appreciation, how much? ₹1,000. Write the amount, ₹1,000. Then stock is valued at 10% less than the book value. How much is the value of stock? Refer the balance sheet given in the problem. Stock value was 10,000. So 10,000 means 10% less. 10,000 into 10%, this is the value to stock account. Stock account, write decrease, don't write depreciation, because it is a current asset. So 1000 here. Anything else? There is an outstanding printing bill for ₹400. Again, on the debit side to outstanding printing bill. Outstanding printing bill. How much? ₹400, isn't it? Yes, it is. ₹400. Now, See which side is greater. Which side is greater? That is credit side is greater. Write the total 8,000. 8,000. Write the same total on the other side. 8,000. Find out the difference. 1,400 this side. So 6,600. 6,600 is the difference. Yes, it is. So this is profit. Credit side is greater. Credit side total is greater than the debit side. So it is a profit. Transfer it to old partner's capital account. To old partner's capital account. Capital accounts. Write the names of the old partners. Who are the partners? That is Sharat and Bharat. Sharat and Bharat. So Sharat and Bharat, write in full. I am writing in short form. Their ratio was how much? Sharat and Bharat, 2:1. So 2/3 and 1/3 into 6,600. So right amount, how much it is? 4,400 and 2,200. Is it correct? Yes, it is. 6,600. Right here, profit on revaluation balancing figure. Balancing figure. Profit on revaluation balancing figure. That is what the revaluation profit is. Now let us move on to the next part. Combined capital accounts of partners. Combined capital accounts of partners. Yes, three columns each on either side. There are three partners, including a new partner. So yes, write debit credit. Very important. Debit credit. First point is, you know it very well, write the capital balances by balance brought down on the credit side. Write the names. Names Sharat and Bharat. Sharat, Bharat in rupees. Write in full names of the partners. Sharat, Bharat, and they took new partner. What is his name? Kamath into partnership. Yes, Kamath is the new partner in rupees. Sharat, Bharat, and Kamath. Yes, that's all. Write particulars here. Particulars and names of the partners with rupees. By balance brought down. By balance brought down. Write the amount. Refer balance sheet. Sharat and Bharat. 20 and 20. 20,000 each. That's all. Then refer, are there any reserves? Yes, it is. There is a reserve, rupees 9,000 should be distributed among the old partners in their old ratio. So 9,000 means 6 and 3, correct? So by reserve fund, right here, old ratio 2:1. So 6 and 3. Very simple. 9,000 into 2 by 3 and 9,000 into 1 by 3. So you will get this amount. Then anything else to be done? No accumulated losses, no other reserves or profits. Then there is a profit on revaluation. So revaluation account profit, that is profit on revaluation. Revaluation account debtor to old partner's capital account. Old partner's capital account is credited by revaluation account. See the amount, that is 4,400 and 2,200. Then no other things. Refer problem. New partner should bring ₹25,000 as his capital. There is cash in hand, so past cash entry. He brings in cash towards his capital. Journal entry will be cash account debtor to new partner's capital account. So capital account of new partner is credited by cash. By cash account, capital introduced. Capital introduced. How much? It is 25,000. Remember, goodwill is should be in the new partner's capital account. I'm sorry. 25,000 here. Goodwill is created in the books of the firm. New partner is not bringing any cash towards goodwill. So no entry for that. We have to create goodwill by debiting goodwill account. Goodwill account entry to old partner's capital account. That is the journal entry for creating goodwill. Refer method 3. Journal entries I already gave in my theory class. So goodwill account entry to old partner's capital account. So old partner's capital account is credited by goodwill account. By goodwill. Goodwill account created. Created. That is old ratio 2:1. Old ratio 2:1. That is what you have to do. Then how much is the amount? 2:1. Goodwill of the firm is raised in ₹24,000. So how much should be? 16 and 8. Correct. 16 and 8. 16,000, that is 2:1. 24,000 is the total amount of goodwill. We have to raise it in the ratio of 2:1, old ratio. So 2:1 means 16,000 and 8,000. Yes, it is. Then what else? Goodwill is not written off. It is there in the balance. It should be shown in the balance sheet. It is created. That's all. So let us. Are there any other entries to be made? No. New partner's capital is entered. Goodwill is created. Revaluation profit is credited. Reserve fund is credited. Everything is done. So close the account. Close the account. What is the total? 25,000 here. New partner's capital account 25,000. Write the same total on the other side. 25,000. Then first partner 46,400. Here 33,200. Write the same total on the other side. 46,400. That itself is the difference because there are no entries on the debit side. 46,400. Here 33,200. Itself is the difference. 25,000 itself is the difference. There are no debit entries. So this is the amount that is to balance carried down. balancing figure, balancing figure. So bring down the balance by balance brought down, by balance brought down, write the same amount, 46,400, 33,200 and 25,000, and 25,000, bring down the balance, 46,400, 33,200 and 25,000. Yes, it is. Then we will prepare balance sheet. Yes, let us prepare balance sheet now. Write like this, balance sheet of Sharat, Bharat and Kamath as on April 1st, 2018 within bracket after Kamath's admission. After Kamath's admission, write this and draw the columns, write column headings, liabilities, liabilities amount in rupees assets amount in rupees amount in rupees yes let us solve the problem. Let us take up asset side first. That is cash in hand is the first item, most liquid one. So cash in hand, cash in hand, there is no much movement of cash here, only one inflow is there, opening balance 10,000 given. Then new partner brings 25,000 as his capital, no other cash movements. Goodwill is created in the books of the firm, so cash is not brought in by the new partner towards goodwill. Goodwill is created in the books of the firm, so no cash movements, remember. So 10,000 opening balance, 10,000 opening balance plus cash brought in by new partner towards capital, that is 25,000, 25,000 total, it will be 35,000. No need of preparing cash account here because only two items are there. Simply add it and show it within the bracket, that's all. Then debtors 5,000, debtors 5,000, is there any adjustment? Stock and buildings, furniture, only three items are to be adjusted, and outstanding printing bill is there, that's all. So debtors, no change as it is, write in outer column itself, debtors, how much? 5,000, 5,000. Then stock is there, there is a change, inner column, stock 10,000, stock 10,000 with inner column, there is a change. Stock is valued at 10% less than the book value, so minus, decrease, minus, decrease at the rate of 10%, that is 1,000, so 9,000, 9,000. Then what is the next item? Stock over, furniture 4,000, is there any change? Yes, it is. Furniture, inner column, there is appreciation. Furniture, it is 4,000, I think. Yes, it is 4,000. Add 1,000 appreciation. 4,000, add appreciation. There is no percentage. Straight away given, 1,000 increased. So 5,000 in outer column. 5,000 in outer column. Then comes last item, that is buildings. Again inner column, there is an adjustment. Buildings, what happened? Yes, there is value of buildings is to be appreciated by 7,000. So 40,000 plus 7,000. 40,000 plus appreciation 7,000. 47,000. 47,000. Are there any other assets? Yes, there is one more asset. We have created goodwill in the books of the firm. Goodwill is not written off. That means goodwill remains in the books of the firm. Let me prepare goodwill account here. To make it very clear, let us prepare goodwill account. Goodwill account. Yes, draw the columns. Debit, credit. Yes, particulars, amount in rupees. General entry for creating goodwill is goodwill account debtor to old partner's capital account. So here, goodwill account debtor to Sharat's capital account, Bharat's capital account, correct? So goodwill account debtor to Sharat's capital account to Bharat's capital account. Bharat's capital account, that is how much goodwill we have distributed, we have created by distributing it among the old partners, that is 16 and 8, correct? So 16,000 here, 8,000 here, that's all. No other entries related to goodwill, only one entry we have passed. There are no other entries related to goodwill, so goodwill account remains open. So if we close the goodwill account here, 24,000 on the debit side, there are no entries on the credit side, write the same total on the other side, that is credit side. So this is by balance carried down. By balance carried down, how much? 24,000. 24,000. Bring down the balance. Two balance brought down. Just for your understanding, I just prepared this. It is not asked in the problem to prepare, but to make you understand very clearly. See, the goodwill account is showing a debit balance of rupees 24,000. Anything which shows debit balance should be placed on which side of balance sheet? Asset side. I told you very clearly, right? All assets shows debit balance. All liabilities shows credit balance. So here, goodwill shows a debit balance of rupees 24,000. So place it on the asset side. Goodwill. Don't write goodwill account. This is goodwill as an asset. So goodwill 24,000. Over, right? That's all. No other items on the asset side. Moving on to the liability side. Yes. Creditors 12,000. No change. Creditors 12,000, there is no change. Then bills payable 8,000. Bills payable 8,000. There is one liability for repair bills, am I correct? Printing bill something, yes. And there is an outstanding printing bill for rupees 400 is a liability. So outstanding printing bill 400, that's all. No other liabilities. Last part, that is capitals. Capitals under that Sharat, Bharat and Kamath. Write the final balances in their capital accounts. That is yes, Sharat 46,400. and 33,200, I think. Yes, it is 33,200. And Kamath, 25,000. Yes, it is 25,000. 25,000. Together, it will be 49,79,99,104,600. 104,600. Yes, it is. Now, see whether it agrees or not, it must agree. Liability side, 105, 113, 115, 125, 125,000. Yes, it is. 125,000. Here, 40, 49, 54, 94, 101, 125. Yes, it is. 125,000 degrees. No doubt. Yes. This is how you have to solve a problem. Whenever the goodwill account is raised in the books of the firm, but is not written off. It is not written off. So, no instructions, only goodwill is valued at rupees 40,000. Such instructions are given in the problem. Simply create goodwill in the books of the firm by crediting old partner's capital account only in their old profit sharing ratio. Old profit sharing ratio. So, this is about the third method when goodwill is raised in the books of the firm. So, take problem number is 9, not 9, I will give you problem number 10, Arati and Bharati for your assignment. Arati and Bharati, solve this problem and submit assignment on time. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.